Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how I made this simple waterfall table. Enjoy! The first thing that I had to do was get this slab set up in my router sled and work on getting it flat. It had a little bit of cup that needed to be removed first, and I did this by making two passes, removing an eighth of an inch with each pass. I'm using a half inch top bearing flush trim bit because, I mean, really that's all that I have. I could only remove a quarter of an inch with each stroke, so this was actually pretty tedious. You can see here I missed a spot on the top, and I did that intentionally. More on that later. Now I can work on the bottom side. After I got the bottom flat, I went ahead and sanded it off camera. Now you can see that I'm taping off the cracks. This is to ensure I have a solid seal so that no epoxy will leak out. I'm using Total Boat penetrating epoxy with black mica powder. I'm pouring a relatively thin layer of epoxy first and letting it set up to create a dam so that when I fill in the rest of the voids later, the hydraulic pressure of the new epoxy won't be enough to leak out from underneath the tape. And now you can see the big spot in the middle that I missed with my router. The reason for that is because it's a shallow depression in the wood, and I decided to wait until after all the epoxy was poured before I made the final cleanup pass with the router. With that part done, I moved the slab over to my bench vise so that I can get it in a vertical position so that I can fill some more cracks on the live edge. This slab gobbled up about 5 of these cups. I really just couldn't believe it, to be honest. And with all the epoxy work out of the way, it was time to just start cleaning it up. And here I'm just taking a very shallow pass, maybe a 32nd of an inch. I was going really slow, trying to be careful not to get any kind of tear out or anything that will show up in the finish. Now I can use my circular saw and a straight edge just to trim those edges up nice and square. With the bottom edge cut square, I was able to use my tape measure and I marked up 18 inches from the bottom and then used a straight edge to draw a line connecting the two points. Then I drew a couple of vertical lines just to help me line it back up later. Then I was able to take my circular saw and set it to a 45 degree angle and using a straight edge, make a cut all the way across. This was the most nerve-wracking part. And of course I forgot to hit record whenever I flipped it back around and made the other cut. Using my biscuit joiner, I made three cuts on both pieces, referencing off the vertical lines I just drew to ensure that they are aligned properly. The biscuits will have enough face grain contact inside the joint to make it very strong, whereas it would be pretty fragile without them. And here I'm just using super glue and masking tape to glue down the cauls that I'll be using to clamp this miter joint together. And in hindsight, I should have oriented the masking tape parallel with the grain. It would have made it a lot stronger and had an easier time clamping it down. Putting masking tape on the inside of the joint ensures that there is minimal cleanup later. You can see here how the 45 degree bevel on both of the cauls directs the clamping force perpendicular with the miter joint, getting it nice and tight. So with the hard part done, now it's just endless sanding. Can't forget to put my name on it. I'm applying a generous amount of teak oil and letting it soak in for about 10-15 minutes before wiping it off with a paper towel. And then I'm applying three coats of shellac, sanding with 220 grit in between coats, and then on the last coat, buffing it out with some steel wool. Now we can move on to the base. I decided to make this out of 1.5 inch square tube with a 1/4 inch wall. And here we're using my father-in-law's bandsaw. I don't have any metalworking tools, so he was happy to help me out. We drilled three holes in the tube with just enough clearance to allow a wood screw to go all the way through, and then we came back and countersunk them. Now we just weld it all together. This is probably the most tedious part of this whole project, and you can see my father-in-law just sitting there watching. And after a couple of coats of primer and a couple of coats of paint, this was ready to be installed. When I set the piece down into place, I used a tape measure to ensure that it was square with the opposite leg. Didn't want it looking crooked. And then I used a screw to transfer the hole locations onto the slab. And with that leg installed, it was time to flip it over, and I was not anticipating how much heavier it had gotten. More sanding, more oil, more shellac. And guys, if you enjoyed the content, make sure you hit subscribe and let me know what you think. And don't forget to leave a like and share this video with your friends. There's also a link to my Instagram down in the description below, along with a link to my Patreon page if you want to support what I do. Thanks for watching.